Hi everyone, now we are at lecture number 6, Integral Calculus. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about applications of double integrals, particularly finding area of regions by using double integrals. So now let us enter into the session. Applications of double integrals. So double integrals have large number of applications, okay, large number of applications. We state some of them only. Okay, we state some of them. So first application number one. Double integration dx dy, only dx dy. That means there is integrand instead of f of x comma, you are having one here. Nothing is there, means here one. Only dx dy. Variation in x direction, variation in y direction. And this gives, and here you write r, double integration over r, where r is a region. Okay. So double integration over r dx dy, which gives you area of the region r. So this is region r. Okay. That is, it gives the area of the region r in Cartesian coordinate system. Okay. Similarly, if it is in polar, so obviously Jacobi will comes into picture. So dr d theta is obvious, right? So x is way. X is modifying to r and y is modifying to theta. So since they are polar coordinate system, so Jacobian will come extra. So Jacobian is nothing but r here. Already we computed in the last class. If you take x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, you compute the Jacobian, you will get r. So that r will come into picture. So double integration r into dr d theta over the region r, over the region r, and this gives you area of the region r, this particular r. If you keep r is a circle, they will get area of the circle. If you keep r is a rectangle, you get area of the rectangle. If you keep r as an ellipse, then you will get area of the ellipse, like that. Okay. So that is, it gives the area of the region r in polar coordinates system. Okay. So based on this, we are going to compute areas of some regions. And how this formula is generates. So look at here, roughly I will explain. You look at in one dimensional, if y is equal to f of x is a curve, okay, if y is equal to f of x is a curve, then how to find area of this? For example, if this is a curve, assume this is y is equal to f of x, okay, this is y is equal to f of x, okay. And this is x-axis and this is y-axis, let's say. Okay. Now, so area under this curve is nothing but, so between the ordinates, let's say this is A and let's say this is B. This is B. So area under the curve, that means this entire portion, right? So this portion we get. This is in, for one dimensional case, okay? Area under this curve you will get. That means how to get this area under this curve? Integration y dx, right? And x limits is supposed to write here a to b, okay, a to b. So from a to b, actually what is the meaning of this area under the curve y is equal to f of x? Y means the curve y is equal to f of x. Between the ordinates x is equal to a to x is equal to b, above x axis, above x axis. Otherwise you will get area under this curve means what? Up to this also can calculate, below x-axis also can calculate, but above x-axis here, dx, x-axis will bounce that. So between ordinates x is equal to a to x will be and above by x-axis. Same thing, how I am modifying is, look at, so this is area of the region, right? Area of the region. So now integration, okay? So y, can I write y as like this? Y is equals to integration dy. It's correct, right? Because derivative integration cancel out. So this derivative integration cancel out, so that you will get y only finally. So y I can write integration dy. So same thing I am going to replace here. What is y? Y is equal to integration dy. That's it. So instead of this fellow y, what I am replacing? I am replacing here integration dy. And what else remain? Dx is remain. That's it. So now with respect to x only a to b, now extra y also came. So both the directions you have to take. Both the direction means you will get some region. That region, let's call it is R. So now you'll get this is area of the region R. Hope you understood this. So area of the region R. Area of the region, that's it, nothing else. Okay, so based on this, let's have some problems. Problem number one simple problem: find the area of a rectangular region R which is bounded by the lines x is equal to a, x is equal to b, y is equal to c, and y is equal to d. Now let us sketch first. Okay, the region . So this is x axis and this is y axis. Okay, now x is equal to a and x is equal to b parallel to y axis, right? So now call this one x is equal to a, assume the rough diagram, and this is x is equal to b. So assume these two points are a and b. So this is a and this is b. So the lines which are parallel to y axis passing through a and b are said to be x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Therefore this line, So therefore this one is x is equal to a, okay, and this is x is equal to b. Fine. Next one, y is equal to c and y is equal to d. So let's call this is y is equal to c, and so therefore this is y is equal to c, y is equal to d, this one, and this is y is equal to c. Okay, and these are, this point is C and this point is D, right? Now, so this is a bounded region, right? So this is a bounded region, and this region I am calling it as region R. So that is the region R, so R, okay. So find the area of the rectangular region R which is bounded by this four line segment. So now this area we are going to calculate. So without using double integration, you can calculate the area of this rectangle. What is this length? What is this length? It is a b minus a, right? This length only, b minus a. Therefore this length is b minus a. This length is b minus a. Okay, area of the, sorry, length of the rectangle is b minus a. What is this breadth? This length from here to origin to here is d, length is d, and origin to this first line y is equal to c is c. So overall this length is how much? D minus c. Now you are having length and breadth. So therefore area of the rectangle is, without using double integration, area of the rectangle is equals to l into b, right? Now what is l here? L is b minus a into breadth is how much? D minus, that's it. Or square units, because it is a area. That's it. Now let us verify this one by using double integration. Right? Now let us enter. So area of the region R, or simply rectangle, whatever, area of the region R is nothing but double integration, okay, over R we need to write. So area of the region R is nothing but double integration over R dx dy, only dx dy. And how to involve the region here, because you are not writing integrand as nothing, only 1 into dx dy we are writing. So we are involving the limits here. So R limits, the region limits we have to write here, okay? So dx dy, and now look at x limits. X varies horizontally. So in horizontal direction, x starts here and end here, right? Okay. So therefore, lower limit for x is a. So x is equal to a. And upper limit for x is b. It varies horizontally, right? So in this direction, look at the graph. So starts here and ends here. Starts here, ends here. Look at the graph. Look at the region. Start here, ends here. So lower limit is this line, that is x is equal to a. Upper limit is this line, that is x is equal to b. So similarly, now y limits. Okay, how to vary y should vary in vertical direction, right? So look at the graph now. So that means starts here and ends here. Look at start here, ends here. Starts here, ends here. So starting from the line y is equal to c and ending to the line y is equal to d. Therefore here y is equal to c to y is equal to d. This is for y. So integration, double integration dx dy. So dx dy. That's it. So since both are independent variables x and y, you can evaluate with respect to x first or y first, your wish. Since I have written a second y limit, therefore you write here y, then after that x. So therefore integration x is from a to b, right? Integration y is from c to d. So with respect to y, after that I want to evaluate with respect to x. Okay, so now evaluate this. So therefore this is implies integration x is equal to a to x is equal to b, isn't it? And evaluate this integration dy is just y only, and y limits you supposed to apply, and y is equal to c to y is equal to d, y is equal to d. Okay, so this implies x is equal to a to x is equal to b, right? And this is d minus c, d minus c into y. Here is dx, right? Into dx. So into dx. So with respect to x, we have to evaluate next. So now d minus c is a constant, will comes out. Integration dx is just x only, right? And substitute the limits x is equal to a to x is equal to b. X is equal to a to x is equal to b. That's it. So you will get b minus a into d minus c. That's it. So this is area of the region R. So square units. Square units. That's it. So this is area of the rectangular region we got here already. Look at b minus a into d minus c. So here also b minus a into d minus c. So next one, problem number 2. Find the area of a region S, which is enclosed by the parabola y is equal to x square and the line y is equal to x plus 2. So you can apply whatever the technique your wish, but here particularly we are in double integration, so that's why we are going to apply the double integration technique. Okay, now first of all you sketch the region. Okay, after that we can think of the area of the regions. Okay, so this is x-axis and this is y-axis, right? So now let us draw x square is equal to y, so parabola having y-axis as a central axis. Okay, so this is a parabola, assume the rough diagram, sharp one. Yeah, next one, the smooth curve here at origin, and y is equal to x plus 2. So y is equal to x plus 2 means x plus 2, then you write like this, x minus y is equals to minus 2, right? Y to right hand side and 2 to left hand side. So this I can write x divided by minus 2 plus y divided by plus 2 is equal to 1. Now this is a coordinate line, right? And this intersect x axis at minus 2 comma 0 and y axis at 0 comma 2. Okay, it intersect y axis at 0 comma 2 and x axis at minus 2 comma 0. Then let us plot this. So assume this is the point which is minus 2 comma 0, minus 2, since it is an x axis, therefore minus 2 comma 0. Okay, and let us take this point is 2, since it is an y axis, therefore this is 0 comma 2. Okay, now let us draw the line. So which is passing through these two points. So this is a line, right? And this line is, what is this? Y is equal to x plus 2. Okay, if you don't know the flatting, then take few points, okay, 4 to 5 points you take and plot on this xy plane, then add those points so that you will get the required graph if you don't remember the shapes, okay. And the required region is, what is that, find the area of the region S which is enclosed by this parabola and the line. So the region enclosed by these two curves is nothing but, so this is a region, so this is a region, so this is a shaded one. The shaded one is the required region, isn't it? So therefore, and this is our what S, this is our S, the region S. So therefore, the region of the required region is, so area of the region S, okay, of the region S is equals to double integration over S we have to write. Okay, over S, what I want dx, dy. Okay, and here we have to involve S for the limits. Okay, now look at here. Cleverly, how to choose with respect to x first or with respect to y first. Now look at, in this, x should vary horizontally and y should vary vertically, right? Now look at, in this, horizontal, look at for x limits first. Okay, x starts here and ends here. Then up to this point, let me mark this, up to this point of time, I am splitting into two parts. So this below one is one portion, upper one is one portion. Now entire region, yes, I am splitting into two pieces. Let's say this is S1, this is S2. Okay. Now below one, lower bound is always this curve, right? And upper bound is also same curve, up to this one. But after this, that means in S2, upper bound is this line, and lower bound is this line, blue line, but upper bound is this curve, y is equal to x square. So, you are getting two different kinds of regions if you treat x is dependent. Okay. X is dependent, you will get these two kinds of regions. Let me write those limits also. Yeah. So, now x limits. So, if you split this one into S1 and S2, S1 and S2. Now first, so below one is S1, let's say this is S1, so let's say this is S1 and this is S2, let's say this is S2, upper one is S2, below one is S1. Now in S1, now I am writing x limits, okay. So for x limits, x is varying horizontally, therefore lower bound is this curve. What is this curve now? Actually this entire is y is equal to x square, right? This is y is equal to x square. So clearly, what I can say, what is x value plus or minus root y indirectly, isn't it? Square on both sides, square root on both sides, we had x equal to plus or minus root y. So if you take plus root y, so if you take x is equal to plus root y, so this is x is equal to plus root y. Why? Because x is positive in first quadrant. In second quadrant, x is negative, therefore this portion is x is equal to minus root y. Okay, this is minus because it is in second quadrant x sign is negative. So therefore the limits here is here the limits are, lower bound is this curve, right? Look at in S1 only, region S1 only. Lower bound is this curve, therefore minus root y to plus root y, because starting with the same this curve, ending with the same curve only, but since it is in a different quadrants, it differs with the sign, plus sign, minus, like that. Okay, come to in S2 and here only, and what are the y limits now? So these are dependent, therefore I need to create x, y should be independent. Okay, now y limits, y should vary vertically. So therefore it vary like this, right? So here to here, like this, here to here. Look at S1 only, domain S1, right? So for y, lower bound is this, starting with the origin, right? So lower value is 0 for y. So lower value is 0. What is upper value? Upper value is this line, this red line. But what is this line equation? Before finding this line equation, I want this value first. Intersection of the line and the parabola. So this point required first, right? So let us calculate the intersection of y is equal to x plus 2 and y is equal to x square. Y is equal to x square. y is equal to x square, assume it is 1, and y is equal to x plus 2, it is second one. So solve these two. Now from these two, what you will get? X square is equal to x plus 2. Okay. Then x square minus x minus 2 equal to 0. Then the values of x are minus b plus or minus square root over, right? B square 1 minus 4ac plus 4 to the 8 by 2 into a. So 2 into a is 1, right? And this will be, so 1 plus or minus 3 by 2. That means if you take, it is plus 2 you will get. If you take minus, minus 2, so minus 1 you will get. Okay. So if x is equals to, if x is equals to 2, if x is 2, then what is y value? You take any one of the equation number 1 or 2, whatever. So I am taking 1. So if x is 2, y value is 4. Therefore, what is the point of intersection now? X comma y is equals to 2 comma 4. This first point of intersection, right? Next one, if x is equals to minus 1, then what is y value? Y value is plus 1. Now what is the point of intersection now? So the point of intersection is x value is minus 1 and y value 1. So 2 comma 4 minus 1 comma 1. Okay. 2 comma 4 minus 1 comma 1. So 2 comma 4 minus 1 comma 1. Here it lies. Since x is negative, this will be in second quadrant and this will be first quadrant. Second quadrant minus 1 comma 1. Therefore this point is minus 1 comma 1. Okay. Therefore, what is this line now? This line is nothing but parallel to x axis. Therefore, y is equals to passing through the point 1, y is equal to 1. This line is y is equal to 1. Therefore, now upper bound for y is 1. Look at y limits are independent, x limits are dependent. This is for S1. Now, let us go to the S2. Okay. For S2, look at the second portion, this portion, upper portion. Okay. And here, x is varying from where to where? X should be horizontally, right? So horizontally, starting with the blue line. So therefore, what is x value from here? So y is equal to x plus 2. From this, what is x value? Y minus 2. So therefore, lower bound is y minus 2. Okay. And upper bound, starting with the blue line and ending to the black curve, right? This curve is nothing but y is equal to x square. So therefore, what is x value now? Root y plus root y, because it is in first quadrant, as I said just now. Okay, now x limits are y minus 2 to root y. Similarly, what are the y limits? Y should vary vertically, vertical direction, right? Y should vary vertical direction. So starting with this red line, ending to blue line always. So always lower bound is red one, always upper bound is this blue line. So lower bound is red one. So y is starting with the one, ending to this blue one. Since y is independent, what is the maximum value for this? So the second point of intersection is this one, right? So this is the second point of intersection. And what is this point? It is 2 comma 4. Therefore, what is the maximum value for y? Maximum value for y is 4. So therefore, maximum value for y is 4. So minimum value in this region for y is 1. Maximum value is 4. Therefore, 1 to 4. So y increases from 1 to maximum value 4. Now you take this set of limits. Therefore, this entire integral will divide like this. So double integration over S1. Dx dy, okay, plus double integration over S2 dx dy, and S1 limits you substitute here and S2 limits you substitute here and you evaluate this. Okay, so minus root y to plus root y, 0 to 1. So therefore, let me write here. So therefore, double integration minus root y to plus root y. So these are x limits. Okay. Next one, varying from where to where? 0 to 1. And these are y limits, right? These are y limits and these are x limits. These are x limits. X is varying from minus root y to plus root y. Okay. Since x is dependent here, therefore first with respect to x, after that with respect to y, okay, and plus next double integration, okay, and y limits are from where to where? X limit is y minus 2 to root y minus 2 to here, upper bound is root y for x, okay, and corresponding y limits are 1 to 4. These are independent limits. So first with respect to x, right? So first with respect to x, right? Since x is dependent variable, after that with respect to y. And you're supposed to evaluate this. Okay, you take it exercise. And this is a lengthy one because region is split into two pieces. Why became tricky, a lengthy one? Because we have created here y as x as dependent, x as dependent we created, and y as independent we created, right? Now let us take reverse. Y should be dependent, x should be independent. Okay, that means if we choose here, look at here. Now this, let us call this entire region is S, all at what I said. So now in this region S, look at for x. X is varying horizontally, right? So x is varying horizontally. So now what I'm creating, x should be independent. Therefore, what is the minimum value for x? Minimum value for x is 0. Minus 1. Minimum value for x is minus 1. And maximum value is 2 here. Look at maximum value is 2. Because point of intersection, you look at both the point of intersection. Minus 1, 1 to 2, 4. So let me write S limits here. Because graph is here, that's what I am writing here. Otherwise, I need to draw the graph in the next page. Okay. So now I am finding the S limits. Region S. For region S. Okay. First, X limits. We are creating X is independent. Yeah. So first, X limits. So lower bound for X is minus 1. Upper bound is 2. So maximum is 2. So X is varying from minus 1 to 2. Now you look at Y. For Y, Y should vary in vertical direction. Y should vary in vertical direction. So always starting with the black one, black curve, and always ending to the blue line. So therefore, it is having unique lower bound, unique upper bound. In previous case for x, it does not having unique upper bound, unique lower bound. It's keep on changing. That's what we have split the region into two pieces, S1 and S2. That is the reason. But now in this case, for y, always lower bound is this black curve, and always upper bound is this blue one. So therefore, what is this black one for y? So therefore, for y, lower bound is, what is the lower bound? Since it is y is equal to x square, right? So therefore, it is x square lower bound. And what is upper bound? Upper bound is this blue one. So what is that? X plus 2. Y is equal to x plus 2, right? Look at only one set of limits you got. So by taking this limits also can evaluate. But this is easy compared to this one, these calculations. Because you have to split into two pieces because it is having... it doesn't having unique upper and lower bounds for x. Okay, so cleverly you have to choose which one should be dependent, which one should be independent before you starting the problem. If you start direct like this, whatever the way you start your wish, either you can take this limits or you can take this limits, it doesn't matter. In both the ways you will get the same answer only. You will not get different answer, you will get the same answer only. But you will get a tricky steps, lengthy steps, if you take this kind of set of limits. So cleverly you have to choose which one should be dependent, which one should be independent, so that our calculations become simple. Let us write this one is the first method. So this is my first method. Okay. Now let us take the second method. So second method. Second method. Now in second method, again same area of the region S is double integration over S dx dy. Now let us go back for the limits. Okay, what are the limits now here? x is minus 1 to 2, y is x square to x plus 2, x square to x plus 2, y value, right? Y is x square to x plus 2. And what is x value? X value is minus 1 to 2, minus 1 to 2. Since y is dependent here, so with respect to first y, after this, with respect to x next. Okay, with respect to x next. That's it. Look at only single set of limits you have to consider here. If you take this kind of region, this kind of limits. Okay, here x is independent, here x is independent, x is independent, and y is dependent. Okay, yeah, now this will be first with respect to y, right? So x is from minus 1 to 2, minus 1 to 2. Evaluate this dy means just y only, and the limits are from y is equal to x square to and y is equal to x plus 2. After that, with respect to x. Now, so this will be x is minus 1 to 2. Substitute upper and lower limits here. What will get upper and lower limits? Upper limit is x plus 2, lower limit is x square. So x plus 2 minus x square. Right? So x plus 2 minus x square. And this one with respect to x. Okay. Now this will be so this will be x square upon 2, right, plus 2 into x minus x power 3 by 3. Okay, after this, substitute the upper and lower limits. So lower limit is x is minus 1 and upper limit is x is 2. Okay. So now upper limit 4 by 2 is 2 plus 4, 2 to the 4 minus 8 by 3. This is upper limit. Okay. And minus, what is the lower limit? Substitute minus 1. So 1 by 2, isn't it? So minus 2 and plus 1 by 3. So this will be the lower bound. So therefore, here 2 plus 4, 6, 6 minus 8 upon 3. Okay. And here minus half plus 2 minus half plus 2 minus 1 third. Okay. And 6 plus 2 here 8 and minus 1 by 2. So this 6 plus 2 8 minus 1 by 2 is over. Next minus 8 by 3 minus 1 by 3 minus 9 by 3. Minus 9 by 3. So finally 3 1s are 3 3s are. So 8 plus 3 11, 11 minus half. So this will be how much? Okay. It is this one 8 minus 3 is 5, right? So this is 5. 5 minus half. 5 minus half, 2 for the 10, 10 minus 1, 9. So 9 by 2. So 9 by 2 square units will get. 9 by 2 square units. So take this this set of limits. So this is the final answer. Take this set of limits and evaluate this. Here also we'll get the same, we'll get 9 by 2 square units. We'll get try once. Okay. 9 by 2 square units. Okay. Next one. Similarly, problem number 3. X square plus y square is equal to r square by double integrals. So first you sketch. Okay. Since center is origin, right? X minus 0 whole square, y minus 0 whole square is equal to r square. So radius is r, center is origin. So center is origin and radius is r. Assume it's a rough one. So center is at origin and radius. This radius is how much? Radius is r, r units. Okay. Now this is x square plus y square is equal to r. Right? This is x axis and this is y axis. Okay, now you can evaluate in Cartesian form, no problem, but you will get lengthy steps. Instead of evaluating in Cartesian form, let us go to the polar form. since the region is a part of circular kind of, since r is keep on increasing, r is keep on changing, right? So starting with 0 to r radius. Okay, so now once r is changing, so let's write here x square plus y square is equal to a square, you write. Write a square. Okay, a square. So therefore here you write region a. Now radius is changing from 0 to a. Okay, let me write this clearly. So let me write with a different, assume it is a. Region is, radius is a. So therefore this is a. Radius is a. So now radius is changing from 0 to a. So radius is keep on changing now here up to a. So you can take, you can apply the polar system. Okay. Now the area of the region. So area of the region. I'm separating region here is a different one, right? So area of circle, area of the circle x square plus y square is equal to a square. So now this will be double integration. So now here instead of region you're having circle x square plus y square is equal to a square into dx dy. Like this you can write it. So instead of s we are writing this one, or if you want to call this one is some r, let us call this one is r and write here r, where r is this circle. Like that also you can do it. Okay, now this will be, so instead of evaluating in Cartesian form, I want to evaluate in polar coordinate system. Now r into dr d theta, r into dr d theta, right? Now r limits, radius is varying from where to where? So radius is varying from, our aim is to find area of this entire circle. Okay, radius is from starting 0 to a, increasing to a. Okay, because I want area, right? This entire inside portion I want. So therefore you start with the origin, so keep on increase the radius. So in both the directions, all the in all the directions like this, it will expand. It will, if it is expand a unique length in all the sides, you will get a circle finally. Okay, so that's what r starting with a 0 and ending to a. And theta, corresponding theta, since we want entire circle, therefore 0 to 2 pi angle, 360 degrees. For example, if you want in only in a second quadrant, for example, only in second quadrant, then what are the limits, can you guess? In second quadrant, area in the second quadrant. Area in second quadrant, only second quadrant. How to get the limits? In second quadrant means minus a to 0. Therefore, r limits are minus a to 0, isn't it? Minus a to 0. And theta limits are where to where? So pi by 2 to pi. Pi by 2 to pi, like this. So these are theta limits, like that. If you want in third quadrant, again same, minus a to 0 only, and the theta limits are pi to 3 pi by 2, likewise. If you want area in fourth quadrant, what is r limits? 0 to a now. R is 0 to a, and theta is 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi, likewise. If you want in first quadrant, r is 0 to a, and angle 0 to pi by 2, likewise. Okay, since we want entire circle, therefore 0 to 2 pi, and radius is, sorry, radius is from where to where? Minus a to a. Okay, this is minus a to a. Okay, minus a to a. Our radius is increasing from here to here, right? Minus a to a, from this point to this point, minus a to a. Now let us find out the area. So since both are independent, you can evaluate first with respect to r, or first with respect to theta, your wish. So I am evaluating first with respect to r. So theta is from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, now it is r square by 2, and here you will get one confusion. Okay, r square by 2, and r limits are from where to where? Minus a to a, minus a to a d theta, right? And now what you will get, substitute upper and lower limits, a square by 2 minus a square by 2, you will get 0 here, isn't it? So integration of 0 is 0, but does the area is 0? It is wrong, right? So therefore we need to change the way of evolution. Look at once again, with respect to r, I'm evaluating r square by 2. Substitute upper and lower limits. Upper limit is a, so a square by 2 minus lower limit is minus a. Minus a whole square is a square only. So a square by 2 minus a square by 2 you will get. A square by 2 minus a square by 2, that will be 0. So 0 into d theta is 0. So you will get 0. So instead of evaluating like this, we need to change the mode of evaluation. It doesn't mean that area is 0. Okay, we need to change the way of evaluation. Like this I am doing. So therefore, so this entire integral I can write as is equals to, since we want this entire region, right, this entire area, we want this entire area. So here what we are getting trouble because of by taking minus a to a, then you change these limits. Instead of writing minus a to a, so you write 0 to a. If you write 0 to a, that means only look at the first quadrant. Look at the first quadrant. Look at only first quadrant. I want to find this first quadrant area. So 4 into I am writing. So 4 times, right? So 4 into theta is from 0 to pi by 2, 90 degrees. Why I am writing 4 into? Because I want entire circle. So this is first quadrant area is similar to remaining quarters areas individually. So first quadrant area is equal to second quadrant area is equal to third quadrant area is equal to fourth quadrant area. The circle piece, sector area, right? So therefore, that's why 4 into 0 to pi by 2, and radius I'm writing 0 to a. Now that kind of trouble you will not get. Now r into dr, after this, we evaluate with respect to r into dr here, okay? R into dr, after this, you write d theta. That's it. So now this will be, hope you understood. This will be 4 into first with respect to r. So integration theta is from where to where? 0 to 90 degrees. 0 to 90 degrees. Right. And it is r square by 2. And r is varying from 0 to a. 0 to a into d theta. Now this will be 4 into integration theta is from 0 to 90 degrees, 0 to 90 degrees, okay, r square by 2, so a square by 2, substitute the limits, upper and lower limits, a square by 2 into d theta, okay, and this will be a square by 2 is constant because integration with respect to theta, a square by 2 will send out d theta, integration d theta is theta, and the limits are from where to where? Theta is equal to 0 to theta is equal to pi by 2, and in front 4 into, right, 4 into, and this will be 4 into a square by 2 into a square by 2 into pi by 2. What do you get? 2 to the 4, 4 4 cancel out, you will get pi a square. You get pi r square, right? Area of the circle pi r square, r is a radius, so pi a square. Okay. So next problem number 4. Using repeated integrals, find the area bounded by the arc of the ellipse in the first quadrant. So you want in the first quadrant, first you draw the ellipse. Okay. Now ellipse. Assume in this a is more than b, okay, and this length is how much? This length is a, right? Because x square by a square, so it intersect on x axis plus or minus a comma 0, right? So this point is minus a comma 0, so this is minus a comma 0, minus a comma 0, and this is plus a comma 0, and intersect at y axis at 0 comma plus or minus b, therefore this point is 0 comma b. And this point is 0 comma minus b, right? Yeah. Now what I want only this area, only first quadrant area. I want this area only this area I want. Okay, this area I want. Now let us start. So area of the ellipse assume this one is some yes assume this portion is yes okay I'm calling this portion is yes area of the ellipse so x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1 in first quadrant right first quadrant is equals to double integration and this we have to write here as a region v square is equal to 1 in first quadrant in first quadrant okay first quadrant dx dy and same thing we can write it as double integration over s I am writing s means look at here shade 1 I am calling this one as s this entire x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1 in first quadrant this entire thing I am calling as s dx dy just for simplicity only nothing else or you, otherwise you have to write this entire ramayana so become tricky one lengthy one so now we are supposed to find the x and y limits here now look at x should vary horizontally and y should vary vertically right now look at in this x is varying from where to where so since this is origin so therefore x is varying from 0 to you consider on first quadrant piece only piece in the first quadrant this region yes shaded one right so x is varying from 0 to a therefore x limits are 0 to a let me write here now region yes limits okay x is varying from where to where 0 to a and corresponding y for each x is increasing from 0 to a y is increasing from x axis so vertical should vary vertically right like this in this direction so it is starting with the x axis starting with the x axis therefore 0 and increasing up to this curve in the first quadrant what is this curve now fine since it is given x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1 so from this what is y square upon b square so y square upon b square is 1 minus x square upon a square isn't it now what is y so bring b square to this side and square root on both sides so that will get b is outside plus or minus right plus or minus b is outside square root over 1 minus x square upon a square okay now here plus or minus we are getting okay so here plus or minus means look at the y look at y y is taking both the values plus or minus so look at first quadrant y is positive therefore first quadrant arc equation is plus you take and look at the fourth quadrant y is negative y is negative therefore in fourth quadrant this equation is you take it is minus so minus b square root over 1 minus x square by a square is here this equation and this equation is what is this y is equal to plus b square root over 1 minus x square upon a square x square upon a square this is plus because it is in first quadrant is positive y is positive okay so therefore y is varying up to this curve so what is that curve b into square root over 1 minus x square upon a square so these are the upper this is the upper bound for y now with this limits let us evaluate the integration okay so we will get this double integral so double integration x is varying from where to where 0 to a right and corresponding y so corresponding y is varying from where to where 0 to b into square root over 1 minus x square upon a square x square upon a square
okay,
into, so since y is dependent, therefore first with respect to y, after that with respect to x, right? Now this will be x is from 0 to a, evaluate with respect to y first, so only y, integration dy is y only, and y limits are 0 to square root over 1 minus x square upon a square, x square upon a square into dx. Now substitute upper and lower limits. What do we get? So integration x is from 0 to a, x is from 0 to a. Now upper limit is, so your b is missing, right? Your b is missing. So b. Yeah. So therefore b into square root over 1 minus x square upon a square. From a square into dx. Now simplify this. So take LCM inside, so a will comes out, so a into, so b by a will comes out. B by a will comes out. Integration x is from 0 to a, isn't it? And here a square minus x square. Okay. Directly you are having formula, you can apply that formula, or simply you can go for trigonometric substitution. Suitable substitution you have to make here. So let us make a suitable substitution so that evolution of the integral becomes simple. Now I am going for, so let, or you can apply the formula, integration a square minus x square, already you are having formula, you evaluate with that formula, or directly by choosing a substitution, let x is equal to some, let us choose a into cos theta. Choose like this. Okay. Now what is dx? Dx is equal to, so let us write sin theta, so unnecessarily minus will come. You can take cos theta also no problem. Okay. So sin theta, a sin theta. Now what is dx? A cos theta d theta. A cos theta d theta. Right? And corresponding upper and lower limits I want. So if x is 0, if x is equal to 0, then what is theta? X is 0, right? So 0 is equal to a sin theta. Then what is theta value now? Theta is 0. Right? Next, if x is, these are old limits, right? Old limits are x is 0 to a. So old upper limit is a. So x is a. Then the new upper limit, a is equal to a sin theta. X is equal to a sin theta, right? So now instead of x, I am substituting a. So sin theta is equal to 1. Therefore, theta is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. Therefore, theta is equal to 90 degrees. Now, with these limits, let us evaluate the integral. So now this is b upon a integration. Now, theta. Theta varying from where to where? Lower bound is 0, upper bound is pi by 2. Now, theta limits are 0 to pi by 2. And integration square root over a square minus x square, a square sine square theta, a square sine square theta, okay, into, remember I am not using polar equations. If I use polar equations, it will be Jacobian will come, right? Don't confuse with that. Just I am going for substitution technique. I am evaluating this integral by substitution technique. Okay, don't confuse with this, okay? Into d theta. A cos theta into d theta, right? Dx. So dx value is a cos theta. A cos theta into d theta. So this is over. Now dx instead of dx, I'm substituting this one. A cos theta d theta. Now this will be b upon a, right? Integration theta from 0 to 90 degrees. 0 to 90 degrees. Right? A square, you take common inside, 1 minus sin square theta become cos square theta. So a square cos square theta will get. So a cos theta will come out. A cos theta will come out, and outside a cos theta is there. Into d theta. So a square will come out, 1a will get into out, so a into b. Okay. So inside, theta is from 0 to 90 degrees. 0 to 90 degrees. We are having cos square theta. Cos square theta. D theta. Okay. So next one use cos square theta formula. So let me use in the second slide. So which is equal to a into b integration 0 to pi by 2
So cos square theta, right? Cos square theta d theta. Now we are having the formula cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1, and one more formula 1 minus 2 sin square theta, isn't it? 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So in this, now this is suitable, right? Because cos square term is present. So now cos square theta become 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2, right? So therefore, a into b, integration 0 to 90 degrees. Okay. What is cos square theta now? Cos square theta from here. Send minus 1 to this side. So 1 plus cos 2 theta and by 2. So 1 plus cos 2 theta. 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay. Integration theta with respect to theta. So therefore, a into b. Integration 0 to pi by 2. Right? 0 to pi by 2. So let me write this 2 is also outside. So 1 plus cos 2 theta only will remain. 1 plus cos 2 theta into d theta. Okay. So this will be ab upon 2. Right? And integration d theta is theta minus cos 2 theta integration sin 2 theta by 2 minus sin 2 theta by 2. So for this overall, theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2, 90 degrees. Okay. So then simplify here itself. So AB upon 2, right? Yes, so upper and lower limits. Upper limit is pi by 2. So pi by 2 minus sine 2 into pi by 2, sine by 0. So upper limit is pi by 2 minus 0 minus lower limit. 0 minus 0. So overall, what you got? Pi AB by 4. This is area of the required ellipse which is present in the first quadrant. So if you want the full ellipse area, full ellipse area. So now this area is how much? Pi AB by 4, right? So this is also pi AB by 4, this is also pi AB by 4, and this is also pi AB by 4. Therefore, overall, how much will you get? So 4 into, so 4 into pi AB by 4. So 4 over cancel out. You will get entire ellipse area is pi into AB, actually. But here the problem is only which is present in the first quadrant only. So square units. Square units. Okay. Next one. Problem number 5. Find the area enclosed by the curve chordioid, which is r is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta between 0 to 180 degrees. So look at the graph. So this is a chordioid graph. Okay. This is chordioid graph. So it will be like this. So starting from 0 like this and ending to up to this is 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi, but I want up to 0 to pi only. That means which is present in first and second quadrant only. So with the shaded one, let us assume this is 1 r. So the shaded region area we need to find. Okay. So some shapes you have to remember. So this is a chordioid. So it's a standard curve. You have to remember its shape. The curve name is chordioid. Okay. Now let us find its area. So therefore, area of the chordioid from theta is equal to 0 to theta is equal to 180 degrees. Which is equals to double integration, what is that? Yes, right? Dx dy. Now look at here, radius is changing, right? Look at r means here radius. So starting 0 to this much length. So So it's keep on changing from 0 to this much length. So therefore you may use polar equations. And angles also given. Angle also changing from 0 to pi. So r and theta varying in this. So you can use polar equations. So therefore this will be double integration over S r into dr d theta. Dr d theta. Now r limits and theta limits is supposed to apply. Now in this, what is theta now? Theta is varying from where to where? Theta varying from 0 to pi. 0 to pi. Isn't it? And corresponding r, r is varying from again 0 to, look at, r is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. Therefore, a into 1 plus cos theta. 1 plus cos theta. So now, indirectly, r is dependent limit. So this is dependent and this is independent. So first with respect to dependent limits, we supposed to evaluate, right? First with respect to dependent limits. So first with respect to r, we supposed to evaluate. Therefore, which is double integration first with respect to r. So r is from 0 to a into 1 plus cos theta. 1 plus cos theta with respect to r first. After this, with respect to theta. With respect to theta. What are theta limits? We want only which is present in first and second quadrant only. Therefore, 0 into 0 to pi. That's it. Evaluate this. And take it exercise, it's a simple one. And with this, I'll stop. Let's take few exercise problems. So, total six problems. Try with